The course profile chart, or sometimes what I refer to as a course plan, a course map, is a central authentic activity or project that you're going to be using in this outcomes-based course that will guide a lot of your other activities. And you're going to essentially be building a plan for your own course. That course or workshop should be 30 hours of instruction. That would translate into a 4 or 5 day workshop. Now, don't worry about the actual hours of the body of instruction that you have. You want to get close to that number. A little bit higher is okay, a little bit lower is fine. It's really important that you understand how these pieces fit together and get that proper alignment that we had talked about earlier on. So if you've got any questions about that, this is something we can discuss in the Skype or Zoom meeting that we're going to have when we talk about whether or not you're going to be looking at competency-based or outcomes-based. And so we can take a look at that length of instruction as well. So I want to re-emphasize the importance of setting up that time to meet with me so we can explore these options. So getting back to this notion of competency-based or outcomes-based education, CBE or OBE, you're going to have to make a decision between one type of instruction that you're going to use. And if you choose competency-based instruction, you're going to develop a DACOM and performance objectives, 10 performance objectives that you're going to have accompanying your DACOM chart. Or if you go with the outcomes-based, you're going to have an outcomes guide and the alignment strategy for that particular guide. So again, I will work with you to help you determine which one of those approaches you want to take. When you make the decisions that you make, that will be assignment 2B, the rationale. So you will identify who your audience is, what their needs are, so on and so forth in that second component, and you will rationalize those decisions that you make, and you've got a 2C assignment, which is your opportunity to resubmit and make adjustments on the feedback that I gave you in part A here. Now, I want to reemphasize something that I've mentioned many times in previous videos before. It's important that you connect with me and talk to me about these ideas, but more importantly, really submit your work within the staggered due dates. And the reason for that is it will allow me the time to actually give you feedback. And I use a video form of feedback or an audio form of feedback where I make recommendations as to how you can improve the work that you're doing. Remember, my job is to help you be successful in what you're doing. And so this is an actual course you're building or redesigning or developing from scratch or a workshop. And so my goal is to help you be successful in doing that. And the feedback that I give you is really to help you build on the foundation that you have built through this coursework, and I really want you to be successful. So please submit your work within the deadline so I can give you the feedback. And also, don't hesitate to set up a time to meet with me to talk to me about making these decisions, right? And that'll help you also through our conversation to work through the rationale component, which I'll talk about in just a minute. Now, there's three parts. You've got part A, B, and C. And each part has its own rubric. And you can take a look at this. I'm not going to explain it. It's very, very well established and self-explanatory. You understand how we will assess the different grades and the different levels that you can achieve. The course rationale is really a document designed to help you justify the decisions you're making. And in making those justifications, I think you can really clarify your thinking. You know, who is your audience? What are their needs? Why did you choose outcomes-based versus competency-based? Or why did you choose competency-based? And then the alignment of your objectives with your goals, if it's competency-based, or your outcomes activities and assessment alignment with the outcomes-based instruction. So you have an opportunity to really justify the decision that you've made. And again, I give you feedback on that as well. This has its own rubric. And then you've got part C, which is really your opportunity to take my recommendations and simply resubmit them. I don't grade this. I don't look at it again. If you submit, you get the full 5 points. If you don't submit, you don't get the points. So again, I want you to take advantage of the feedback that I'm providing you and take advantage of these additional extra points that you can get that can make a difference between sometimes an entire grade point. So keep that in mind. This part is submitted at the end of week 9. So you have some opportunity to take the feedback that I give you on the first part A and part B, make those adjustments, resubmit, and then I can can assign the additional 5 points. So this outlines the core assignment, and from this core assignment, you're also going to build out your lesson planning, your lesson plan, and your syllabus or your outline. So again, this is a central component. I'm going to remind you one more time, set a time for us to meet so we can talk about what your options are and so that I can help you be successful.